In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create this amazing effect inside of Cinema 4D. If you would like to download the project files, head over to tutorsdigital.com to download this and many other project files. Let's begin. I already have a sphere ready in my scene, with its radius and segments set at 50. I also have my timeline set at 1000 frames. To start, I'm going to have the ball randomly float around. So I'll create a null and drag my sphere inside that null layer. Now, for my null layer, I'll do a right mouse click, head over to animation tags, and select Vibrate. Inside of Vibrate tag, under Enable Position, go ahead and check the box. We are now going to change the amplitude values to 500, 300, and 500. Perfect. Now let's hit the preview button. And we can see our sphere move around like a maniac. To reduce the movement speed, go ahead and reduce the frequency to 0.5. When we preview it again, our sphere now moves at a slower speed. Okay, now it's time to add the trail from where our objects will latch on. Select the null layer, and in the MoGraph menu, choose Tracer. We can see our tracer is linked to our null layer. Now, change the limit to from N. Let's preview it, and we should see a tail. It's nowhere to be found. That's because we need to give it an amount. So I'll change the amount to 50. Now, when we preview it again, we can see a tail form. It's time to add the objects that will follow our sphere. Head over and bring in a cloner object. Select the cloner layer, and under its object tab, change its mode to object. Now, in the object section, we are going to drag our tracer layer. When we hit play, we should be able to see our objects. However, we don't see any. That's because we haven't positioned any objects under our cloner layer. So let's go ahead and bring in some 3D objects. I'll add a cube, torus, capsule, and sphere. I'll select all of them and scale them down to a small size. Now, I'll drag them all into my cloner layer. Once they're under, we can see our 3D objects following the tail. I'll hit the play button, and as you can see, it's a nice start. Let's increase the count of our cloner object. Go ahead and select the cloner layer, and under count, increase the amount to any value you like. I'll make mine 300. Hit the preview button again, and you should see something like this. Now, I want the objects to scatter and not be in a straight line. For that, we are going to add a rigid body. Go ahead and do a right mouse click on our cloner layer. In simulation tags, select rigid body. Perfect. Now, let's hit the play button. And, well, that's not what I wanted. Let's fix that. in the rigid body expression, head over to the Force tab, and in the follow position, I will make it 10. Now, when we preview it, our objects should be bunched together. This is looking good. Okay, I now want the sphere to interact with these 3D objects and not just go through them. So I will do a right mouse click on my sphere, head to simulation tags, and select rigid body. Now, when we preview it, we should, well, that's not right. We forgot to increase the follow position to 10. Now, when we hit the preview button again, our main sphere interacts with our 3D objects. Okay, this is looking good. But what if we want the tail section to have a type of fade or vanishing point? For that, I will go ahead and select the cloner layer. Then, head over to the MoGraph menu, and in Effector, go ahead and select the Plain Effector. Uncheck the position box, and check the scale box. Now, let's check the uniform scale, and set the scale value to -1. Once we have this ready, let's head over to the Falloff tab. Instead of using any of these fields, we are going to drag our tracer layer into this space. You will now see a gradient color applied to the objects in the tail. This is to visually tell us what's affected. Let's hit the preview button and... well, my computer is having difficulties previewing this. I'll go ahead and select the cloner layer. And under instance mode, I'm going to select multi-instance. I should now be able to preview my scene without lag. Okay, now seeing this, I can tell you it's having the opposite effect. I want this area to be normal size, and it should scale down as it reaches the end of the tail. So let's select our plane effector layer, choose the tracer field, and under remapping, I'm going to select invert. Now, when we preview this again, I should have the effect I want. Okay, this is what I wanted. I'll play around with the inner offset bar to make the tail have more thickness. I'll hit play again. Okay, it's looking much better. I'll increase the object count to 500. Go ahead and select the cloner layer, and where it says count, increase it to 500. I'll preview it again. I feel the size of the tail is too long, so I'll go ahead and reduce it. Go ahead and select the tracer layer, and reduce the amount to 20. I'll preview it again. Okay, it's looking much better. At this point, you don't have to follow what I am doing, since it's now a matter of preference. I'll go ahead and reduce the inner offset for my plane effector. Okay, you have now learned how to create this amazing effect inside of Cinema 4D. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Also, if you would like to download the assets used in this tutorial, head over to the tutorsdigital.com website, where you can download many other assets used in previous tutorials. Till the next one!